Wisconsin Republican Senator Ron Johnson, you remember, he wondered aloud in the Senate whether those bloodthirsty rioters at the Capitol were fake Trump supporters or maybe Antifa. And now he is forcing the full reading of hundreds of pages of the COVID relief bill. These are the people who are supposed to serve you, who were elected by the American people, and this is the crap that they're pulling. Just because he can. Just because he can. You should be outraged by that. A waste of time and your tax dollars. And insulting to your senses. Wisconsin voters, is this what you want? Is this what you want, Wisconsin voters? A pointless political stunt. You know we're in the middle of a pandemic and every second counts when it gets to getting relief to the American people. This is the biggest political stunt since.
Do you like green eggs and ham? I do not like them, Sam I am. I do not like green eggs and ham.
Oh, the GOP so concerned about Dr. Seuss. So let's consider what Democrats are focused on and what Republicans are focused on. Are you with me? Okay. Here's some more truth telling for you. Democrats moving ahead on COVID relief with zero support from Republicans and moving ahead on voting rights in the bill that the House passed last night. The GOP focusing on Dr. Seuss and defending Neanderthals. Seriously. Though, I don't think they are. Here's what President Joe Biden said yesterday about governors lifting COVID restrictions too soon.
The last thing we need is the Neanderthal thinking that in the meantime, everything's fine, take off your mask, forget it.
Okay, and that set the GOP fake outrage machine into motion. Yes, I said fake outrage machine. Right into motion. They really, really, really want to make this happen.
Neanderthals are hunter-gatherers. They're protectors of their family. They are resilient. They're resourceful. They tend to their own. So I think Joe Biden needs to rethink what he is saying.
Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. The Neanderthals have been extinct for about 40,000 years. And I'm not sure that they need Senator Marsha Blackburn to come to their defense now. Here's the thing. If you don't support the Democrats' agenda and nothing says that you have to, then tell us what you do support. Instead, we've got the GOP's fake outrage machine at work. They just cannot resist. And it is none of it's based in fact, right? I told you about last night about the Dr. Seuss thing. They're saying Joe Biden canceled Dr. Seuss and Democrats. No, it was the company that runs Dr. Seuss. It's Dr. Seuss's company who on their own said, this doesn't represent our company anymore. We're going to take these books out of circulation. But the fake outraged Republicans had to say, okay, well, it's Joe Biden, it's the Democrats. Nothing to do with the Democrats or Joe Biden. It's all a big darn lie. There's Senator Marco Rubio. Oh, Marco Rubio, really? Jumping on the chance to troll President Biden, sarcastically tweeting that he should apologize for using an old stereotype and suggesting that he should seek training on unconscious bias. Okay. Bonus fake outrage points to Mississippi Governor Tate Reeves for circling back to that old favorite, deplorables.
Today, I feel the same way as I did the day that Hillary Clinton called all of us in middle America deplorables.
And then there's Jim Jordan. Never want to miss a chance to stoke the fake outrage machine, still harping on Dr. Seuss.
I think you're right. I think Americans are just fed up with this all. I mean, you know, first it was Kermit the Frog and the Muppets, Mr. Potato Head, then now, you know, Dr. Seuss.
Do they ever get tired of just lying? Are you tired of them lying to you? I don't care if, like, it even if you're a representative and you voted for them, aren't you tired of them lying to you? Because what they're telling you about Dr. Seuss is just a total lie. It's just a lie. Easily exposed. And then there's Tom Norton, who is running for Congress in Michigan's 3rd District, tweeting about Goya beans, Mr. Potato Head, and Dr. Seuss all at once. Remember, COVID relief, people are hurting, they need the money, they need the stimulus, they need it, but they're tweeting about Dr. Seuss and Mr. Potato Head. Okay. Don't fall for it. Don't fall for the old okey-doke. You know, I tell you that all the time. Don't believe that they're upset about Biden saying Neanderthals are Dr. Seuss. Remember all the crap that the former president would say about people would tweet, and then they would pretend they didn't see the tweets? When he talked about Ted Cruz's wife's looks? And on and on. And he calls so many people actually, his thing was to make fake names for people. Lion Ted. Little Marco. And now they're upset about someone saying a name like Neanderthal? You got to really think people are stupid to fall for that one. It is fake outrage. And it's, you know why they're doing it? Because it's all they've got. They don't have anything else. The vaccine's getting out. Joe Biden's moving ahead with his agenda. And he is ignoring their noise and their BS. And Republicans lost the House. Facts. They lost the Senate. Facts. They lost the White House. Facts. And they're still sucking up to the disgraced, twice impeached, one-term former president. But it doesn't look like it is working, because Georgia Governor Brian Kemp said he'll support Trump in 2024, even though Trump demanded that he resign and promised to campaign against him. And what did he get for that? He got slammed by the former president, who claimed Georgia Republicans didn't turn out to vote because they were angry at Kemp for failing to stand up to Stacey Abrams. And then there is Mitch McConnell. Who, in spite of saying Trump was responsible for the insurrection, voted to acquit him. He got slammed, too. And they're all upset about names. Remember when he talked about how many chins this president did that Mitch McConnell has and all that stuff? That's what he wanted to write in the note to Mitch McConnell. He called Mitch McConnell, said he was the most unpopular politician in the country. Like I said, still sucking up to the former president. And while Democrats are working to get COVID relief to millions of Americans, Texas Governor Greg Abbott, with absolutely no evidence, is blaming the Biden administration for releasing migrants with COVID.
The Biden administration was releasing illegal immigrants into our communities who had COVID. The Biden administration was exposing Texans to COVID. That is Neanderthal type approach to dealing with the COVID situation.
All the while in his head, he's thinking, if you had a little bubble over his head, it would say, don't think about the storm. Don't think about the snowstorm. Don't think about the power that was out. Don't think about the water. Here's a shiny object. Governor, I see you. Here's a shiny object. I'm not just picking on Republicans because they're Republicans. Don't get it twisted. I'm picking on them because they're acting like idiots, because they're laughable, because they're easily exposed, as I said, because they have nothing else. And instead of trying to help the people they're supposed to serve, they're playing word games and mind games and little tricks. That doesn't help anybody. Even you, if you voted for them, it does not help you. I will tell you who is exposing Texans to COVID. It's you, Governor Abbott, the governor who is lifting mask mandates and reopening businesses. That's who's exposing people to COVID. The governor who has not responded to the Biden administration's offer of federal funds for COVID tests for migrants. That is the truth, not the lie that they're telling you. The governor jumping on the GOP outrage machine with that Neanderthal comment. So here's where we are tonight. This is where we are tonight. Democrats are working on COVID relief, and they're working on voting rights. COVID relief to help the American people, voting rights to get as many people to participate in our electoral process as possible. And Republicans, here's the mirror. This is what you're working on. Dr. Seuss and Neanderthals. Get with it, people. What is wrong with you? Your stupidity, as my friend would say, your slip is showing.